because they're incredible, and this is going to be super fun, and there's a pool right there, so who knows what's going to happen. I'm just kidding. So first and foremost, I want to introduce the coolest dude ever. You guys know him as Carl Grimes, ladies and gentlemen.
Of doing it in shorts, and we we went down this really steep, and it's on cement, so like we went down this really steep hill. I couldn't stop, so I was like, oh, I'll just kind of like fall down. So I like fell on my butt, and then I just had this huge scratch all over my leg. I was like, yeah.
That scene was actually filmed on my birthday.
What a fun way to come into work.
I can't remember, sorry.
She's like, wait, it was your birthday?
I'm sure I said happy birthday.
Did you get to keep the roller skates for your birthday? They're like, happy birthday, Chandler, here's the skates.
Wait,
I think they actually did give us,
yeah.
I think they did.
I think they gave us like padding.
So how many takes did it? Wait.
But our instructor, do you remember what his name was? It's like, was it Jim or something like that?
Yeah, I think it was Jim.
He was so amazing, guys. He was like straight out of the 70s. He had long hair, just like Chandler. It was gray though, but he had a glass eye and a messed up knee. He was amazing.
He was the best instructor ever, but he hasn't always hated a day in his life. It was incredible.
So how many takes to get that scene just right? Because it was a lengthy scene, and it...
You know, it was scary, though, because, like, the hill was really big, so it was,
Well, they started us off.
Yeah, no, they started us at the very top of the hill, and like, made us, like, go all the way down. We had to, like, run up to the side.
I just crashed in the grass. He stopped somehow. I don't know how he did it.
Expert skaters.
Okay, they're good.
So, let's take a question now. Do we have any questions over there? Do we have a mic? There we go, right here. See the light? There's a light waving. Follow the light right here. This is Mary, lovely Mary. Right here. Here we go, follow the mic, the light.
So, I have a two-part question. First, will we see any more interaction?
Any more action?
Any
action. Oh.
Possibly.
Never talk to each other again.
Yeah.
The kiss was that bad.
Take on like all the situations, like, you would totally be dead like between like, if he didn't die, he'd totally be dead by now by some other reason. But, like, it'd be so cool to, like,
it would.
Have him as, like, another dynamic for the rest of the
world. Thank you. Ouch, that's rough.
You took it to such a dark place, like, threw you under the bus. Not your fault. That's so sad.
I mean, like, yeah, it'd be cool, but, like,
flashbacks,
but I mean, like, for like, dynamics and, like, story-wise, it'd be really cool.
So in terms of dynamics, speaking of that, so you've spoken a lot about learning a ton from working with Andy Lincoln for 7 years now. So now you're working with Jeffrey, and there's definitely a very creepy father figure there. So what's that been? Is there a difference between these two characters? Obviously, and performance-wise there are, but is there something or new things you've learned from just working in the scenes with Jeffrey?
Totally. I mean, it sucks because Jeffrey is such a cool guy, and I have to hate him, and it makes my job so much harder. But he's like, he's such a man, and I'm like so glad I got to work so far. He's just like such an amazing actor. He always comes prepared, and he always like puts in 100% into every single scene. You can just tell he's having fun. So much fun. So much fun.
I don't know if you just heard you mock him just thinking like, not funny. And then we'll take the question in a second, but the prosthetics of the eye. So you took to Instagram when you were allowed to, and you showed off this incredible prosthetic, which I'm sure a lot of fans of the comic books were interested to see how that would be pulled off for the show. So what's the process of getting that prosthetic on? How long does it take? What does it feel like?
Well, obviously we don't have to put a prosthetic when I have a patch on. It's when I'm putting on things being shown. But it takes about, for the first few test runs, it took about like 4 hours, 5 hours to put on. Just because we had to get the coloring right, we had to keep on getting feedback from Greg. But it was all done by Karen Jackson, who was part of the effects team, and she did such an amazing job. We ended up getting it down to about an hour. Mainly just like the biggest thing that helped out was the like, pre-color most of the prosthetic, and Eliza, I just sit there while she applies it, so analyzing me. But it was really nice for change having the prosthetic because you know having the patch on, I constantly have to adjust. Like I can push it up between takes, but I have to keep on adjusting it because this corner ends up like popping up, and so I feel like pushing it down like against my eye, and make sure it's like in the right place so you can't see my actual eye. Having like dodge cameras because if they're right here, they can see my eye, so I can never like be looking right there with the camera. Right there. It's very frustrating. But with prosthetic, I don't have to worry about that. Just like chill for like 11 hours, not worry about having to mess with it, but I didn't have, like, I lost, like, 70 degrees of vision, depth perception, it was quite the thrill.
I remember this one time, I was like, oh my gosh, it's a bug,
what are you talking about, it's like, on this side, like, it's a crazy vision, so. Yeah, people, like, try to hand me stuff from this side, like, shit, I think Ross was, like, handing me a gun one time, and I'm just, like, walking along, pointing it, like, right here, and, like, Chandler, finally, but. Yeah, it's I don't know. I do like prosthetic.
Awesome. So